Alright, back for round two here. Definitely gonna play first. I don't think this is a mulligan. We need more gas, but I don't. I mean, we need more creatures, but I think this is fine. We have quite a few creatures in our deck. Yeah, I'm not sure. I definitely could see mulliganing that hand. Maybe if there was a mountain, it would be like a easier keep. But I don't know, we'll find out. Ew. Alright. Ain't got much worse. Ain't got much better. Yeah, I think our deck's fine. Definitely lacks some interaction that I tend to like with things like this. But I mean, still a fine deck. Now we're gonna kinda tie up his mana for the next few turns, which is not a terrible thing. Drawing a land there also not the worst. I would prefer a mountain just, you know, so we can have our last mana to be able to cast this, but for reasons like that, he should tap this. It'd be sweet if this untapped a creature. Probably be way too good. It's already like way better than Angelic Blessing ever was. The old Whipper Snapper, dude. Uh-oh, got a fatty. Fatties are us. I think I'm attacking, seeing what he does. Obviously, I don't care if he blocks, and then I'm just gonna not do anything. I'm just gonna play the Peregrine Griffin. This is strict free roll attack for me. He either blocks and nothing happens, or he doesn't block and takes three. So, all right, now we need to draw a mountain or more creatures. Either one, I'll be fine with. Or Throne. Throne would be super sick right now. The old giant spider, Gideon's Lawkeeper, defense. The essence of a lawful society is swift deterrence. I see, Lawkeeper. I see. All right, well, I guess we play this guy first in an effort to once again get him to fail to not tap in response. It happened in the first round, it is not happening again. And now I think we go ahead and bash here. He could have like Titanic Growth or something, but I'm fine with Mighty Leaping here, seeing if I get his guy. Yep, he had a growth of some sort. Oh, a stave off. Okay, that's not bad. At least I don't lose my guy. It's just a 1-for-1. Alright, so now this guy's pretty good against Lawkeeper. Pretty good with Lawkeeper, too. Unfortunately, we don't have any. Stampeding Rhino. Okay, we're drawing all of our good red cards. We only have two red cards left in our deck. We have five mountains. He's letting me attack. Alright, obviously not attacking. Let's see if he taps something down. Nope. Alright, so hopefully this Guardian's Pledge is pretty big here. We could take out on a Stampeding Rhino, or we could just take some damage for the next couple turns, growing our Avenger. I'm fine with that too. But we could double block, cast Guardian's Pledge. First strike will get it, and if it doesn't, then this guy gets it at least. Yep, he doesn't even want to attack. Alright, Montagna, or not. Just gonna play our lands in case we do draw red mana, we can fireball him. We're in a stalemate, but I kind of like our position. He probably has an overrun in his hand, if I had to guess. Let's go ahead and drop this man. I could start attacking with multiple things, I guess. If he blocks both, I can get him with the Guardian's Pledge. Maybe that's worth it. He's got a pacifism. Okay. Deal. We do have a couple stave offs, so I'm not too worried about that. Demystifying the board and all that jazz. Like there. All right. Let's go to attacks. Get in there with these guys. He's likely just to double block here, or not double block, but block and block. But if he doesn't, I can get him. I could have attacked with Benellish Veteran as well. but he's not going to. Alright. But this entices, this makes him less likely to block to get him more damage, and if he attacks back, I can stave off to pump this guy, which would be pretty sweet. He's just going to attack with that. Okay. Fine with that. Not going to block that. Next, now I can attack with Veteran and not have to. Like, before, if he makes blocks, I don't even have to use a Guardian's Pledge. That kind of sucks. Alright, well, he goes to 18. Before I can block with, like, he can block Siege Mastodon and then Peregrine Griffin, and I don't even have to use Guardian's Pledge. But if I attack with this, I'm forced to use it, which is a little bit worse. Alright, so I think I just run this guy out. And I sit here. He's going to tap a Siege Mastodon. I guess I could brawl with this. Stave off should get him pretty good here. He's tapping something else. Alright, that's good for me. So yeah, Gideon's Avenger is going to pick off the Stampeding Rhino. In true fashion. Wait for that to resolve. Pro write it up. White. And get my block on. Alright. Pretty happy with how that went. Now I have a 6-6. Big timer. I have one red spell left in my deck, and it is a Goblin Tunneler. Alright, let's get some attacks in here. Brawl. I'm going to leave the Lee Vanguard back, because I don't want to have to use Guardian's Pledge. And right now he has to make some very bad blocks in order for me to have to use it. Alright. Deal. So he takes 6, loses a token. I'm fine with that. I don't have to use the Guardian's Pledge. I'm high enough on life and his team's not very good. Plus he can't even like all-out attack me because he just dies on the backspin. It's kind of awkward in my hand, but we're still doing fine with that, with missing a red. If we ever draw a red, the game's basically over, though. So he should get in with a couple of guys here. Yeah. My Avenger grows in strength. Alright, so we're at 12, not doing too bad. He's going to tap an Avenger for sure. I'm a little worried about Overrun. Uh-oh, what is this? This is a gigantic thing, a Carnage Worm. Alright. That was a good draw. Okay. How do we make this work to the best of our advantage? He's going to tap this. We then have 4 attackers for his 3 blockers. Double pledge, so everything dies except for this, because he'll block here. I basically just don't want to die this turn. But I think if I draw a mountain, I'm pretty set, so I'm just going to could attack here and double pledge. I just don't want to die on the backswing. And let's see, if he chooses not to block with this, if he only blocks 2 guys, he blocks here and here, I guess. He would take 6, 12, I guess he would die. So he has to block with this, but then he has lethal here. Assuming he does, well, he'll block with a Giant Spider, probably, too. Yeah, it's just all kinds of stuff I don't like to happen, so we're just going to wait, hopefully draw a red mana. We can kill this Carnage Worm on the attack with Guardian's Pledge, so. And then once that thing's gone, his board is not nearly as impressive. And I want to block with the least amount of things as to not get wrecked here. Alright, so, let's see. This would be a 7-9, which is gonna take enough by itself. This would be, yeah, I guess I could just, I could also use just use one. If I just like block with both these guys and just use one, then he can't kill both of them, and it'd be four. It'd be exactly 9 power. The only problem is if he has a removal spell like a plummet or a stave off, it's bad for me. So I would need to throw this guy into the mix, but then he could kill. I guess he can't kill this plus anything else either. So, alright. So we're going to go here, here, here. And then this way, with a Guardian's Pledge, he can't kill any two things. So we'll wait for him to order his blockers. Griffin first, makes sense. Currently not even killing his guy, but this puts it over the top. If he has a stave off here, it's bad, but I only lose one guy, so it's not too big of a deal. Alright, so just make sure we have 4-6 and then a 5-7. So yeah, he can't kill them both. Works for me. Trade a Peregrine Griffin for a Carnage Worm. That is big. Salt Griffin. It's kind of gross. Thank you. Finally got there. Alright, so I can, if I Grim Lavamancer here, it's not actually that good. I could just shock this. I could shock this, and then the beats begin. Guess I just attack. Let's see. He has 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. He has 9 power total, so I'm just going to, he's going to tap this, and I'm just going to brawl with the rest of the team and see what happens. I could also get this for 2 and this for 2 and kill his 2 best creatures, which is not terrible with this fireball. But if I make this attack, I get more information, and I could just shock one of these things. We'll see how this works out. I feel like this is going to die, and at least 2 of these are going to die, and then I can just shock this, and then we're way ahead on board. Alright, that's fine by me. Let's cast this. So both those guys die, so he loses 2 guys, and we get in for 5. Which is pretty sweet. I then get to play a mountain. I guess I should have played the mountain potentially first to get that, but it gives them so much information. Kill off the Assault Griffin now. I assume he doesn't have a giant growth or he would have saved his guy. Now his offenses are pretty bad. He still has to block a bunch of stuff, and I have Fireball, which is 1 away from lethal. So, we're up a land, he's dead. Or if we get in for any damage here. I think that worked out. Even Overrun does get us here. If he played Forest Overrun, we'd be dead. Or if he just tapped this, we would not be dead. So he has to play Forest Overrun to get us here, which he very well could have. Let's see what he does here. Hopefully we just rip a land and are able to fireball. Otherwise, I can go 1-1-1. See, 1, redirect 1, redirect 1. So, yeah. Which is probably enough to get it done. He'll tap this. He'll block one of these. He'll take 5. Ooh, he's getting in with a Llanowrelf. Okay. Interesting. 'Throne of Empires. A little late to the party, but that's okay. So I can go 1-1-1. Then he taps this, he blocks, I guess I just attack with everything. If I get him for 2, he's dead. Yeah. I will lose my Benelish Veteran and my Elite Vanguard this turn, but assuming he doesn't have a way to gain life or something. Yep, and then this will block here. Takes 3, goes to 4. I can't think of a spell that gains life here. So we're just gonna, that's it, that's the only target. just tap out because it's irrelevant if I have any mana left over. Alright. That was an interesting game. Having a bunch of red spells in our hand most of the game. So, Demystify, good against Pacifism. Stoneheart Dignitary, not too good. Wall Torch is not terrible. Circle Flame's good against Timely Reinforcements. It's good against Llanowar Elves. I mean, basically a bunch of crap I don't care about, to be honest. Tunneler seemed like it'd be kind of sweet. Yeah, I don't think I want anything gone. I think our Slaughter Cry is pretty absurd. We just didn't have red to really get it out early. Wall of Torches could be better than Goblin Tunneler, but his deck was kind of slow, so I'd rather just like jump on him early and see how that works out for us. So yeah, I like it as is. We'll just be back for game two.